So today I decided to do a little experiment. And the experiment is to compare the results between the mixing in silicone and spraying on silicone on the paint. So the colors that I'm going to be using is white and red, and I already pre-mixed them with the 50% of the paint and 50% of the floetrol. Plus, I added roughly a teaspoon of water to achieve that very nice running consistency. And so we'll be using those two colors. And first, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually mix two reds and two whites. So, okay, so I have my cups, and let's do spray on silicone. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm using the 100% silicone for the treadmill belt. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pour half of the white paint. There you go. And then I'm gonna spray on. Now I'm gonna add red. Spray, finishing with white, spray, and again red. So, and here I'm gonna use silicone right inside. So I'm gonna do, I guess I'll do two sprays. I totally did here three, I think. Yeah, well, let's do one more small one. Okay, now we're gonna mix it. So first of all, you can see, I think, immediately the difference between two, and I don't know why my camera is showing this as an orange, but it's a bright red. And now we're gonna do a flip. Okay, so unfortunately my camera stopped and I didn't realize that. But here are the results. So what I did is I just basically did a flip cup, and I moved the paint around. So I started from that corner, then I moved to that corner, then to that and that. So here you can see the result for spraying on silicone. And here is the actually mixing silicone. So I must say that obviously it depends what are you looking for, what result you're looking for, but this one definitely has more vivid cells with a nice contour, while this one is a bit like a marble effect, I would say. Especially that part. So, yeah. So here's a little experiment. Spray on versus mixing. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon. Thanks.